Hello and welcome to Quick Teaching Tips. This video will show you a super simple way to create mind maps with your students in a collaborative way called Dump, Clump and Connect. Mind maps are a great tool that allows students to take a broad view of the topic being taught and make connections between the different details and concepts they are just learned. You can make mind map at any point in the teaching process, but in my view, the best time to do it is once students have received the information and explanation of a chapter they need to master. It is a great recap and revision tool, an ideal interactive way to revise. You will need post-it note, use cut pieces of paper if you don't have enough. Let's get started. Divide your class into groups. Some interesting way to divide the class is given in my earlier video. Choose a topic to mind map and give each group a topic to work on. As an example, I will be using the chapter on plants from this textbook which I have contributed. First step is called dump. When you do this exercise with your students, they will work together. Ask them to use headings of tables, bold words, captions of pictures to help them find words to put in their dump. So here you can see some big headings like herbs, shrubs, trees, creepers, climbers. So they can write these in their post-it pad. So they can keep on adding the words, whatever they get in bold or the title of the page or the heading of the table. Just remember that one word per card. So all the words, all the keywords can be dumped together on a board and then let them find out which words are related. For example, stem is related with node and internode. Root is related with fibrous root, taproot. Leaf is related with venation, parallel reticulate. So they can clump together this. The type of plants, herbs, shrubs, tree, creeper, climber, they can be clumped together according to their structure of the stem. So these are different clumps. So what we can do is, we can write so this way you can arrange it. So this will become a very nice mind map. There are many digital mind mapping tools available on the web. Some are free and some require a little subscription. I have used the following: Google, Mapple and Free Mind. Today I will show you how to create the mind map on Mapple because I find it easiest. The link to Mapple can be found in the description below. You can try a free version to see if you like it. First, register on the site and log in. The login button is given below. Then it will bring up the landing page. On the taskbar above, click on Create and it will open up the dialog box like this. Now you can type the name of the central idea, like plants. My idea here was plants, so I'm typing that in. Next, let's go to brainstorming tab. Now you can list the different types of clumps you had made. Enter each type of clump in a separate line. Once you have done that, hit the create button. So now you have the basic skeleton of a mind map. but it is not looking clear and nice. We can say change the shape, size and color of the arms of the mind map simply by toggling the enter key. Note that at the end of the arm, there are two types of icon, a blue cross and a green pen. The blue cross icon will allow you to change the shape of the existing arm of the mind map. You can make it stretch or shrink. You can make the text bigger or change its color, as you can see in this video. You can also create boxes by choosing the option from the dialog box, as I have done for putting in the definition of photosynthesis, transpiration, etc. To add more branches, you will need to click on the green icon and drag it. If you make a mistake, highlight the branch and click on the delete icon at the bottom bar. In case of digital mind mapping, you have to start from the central idea and move outwards towards the details. So connect the central idea to clump to the sorted dump. When we do it physically, it's better to dump first and then clump and connect, though both will work. You can make it as simple or as detailed as you need, depending upon which class you are working with. Finally, you can only save the map by exporting it as a JPEG or use the snip tool on Windows by pressing the Windows key, the Shift key and S together, and then selecting the map and pasting in a Word document. You can then add more notes or create a worksheet or print out to stick it in the notebook. Also remember that each time you create a mind map, it will be different. A mind map is a living note. Encourage children to constantly add to their mind maps. They can add new branches, pictures, definitions as the topic becomes more and more complex and their understanding of the topic becomes deeper. If you enjoyed my video, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe before you leave. Looking forward to seeing you at my next video. Happy teaching!